I've never really seen myself doing anything besides music. I enjoy other things, of course, but I'm absolutely addicted to writing and recording music and performing. Even if I try to quit, and I do try to quit. like once a year or so, I'm like, this is it. I'm tired of this. I can't do this anymore. It doesn't work. I mean, I'm like right back at it the next day. You know, it really is an addiction. Minimalist, you know. I like my house that way, I dress that way, sing that way. I like to think I write and record songs that way too. Is the record minimal too? I think so. The arrangements are really boiled down, simple, and what I hope are memorable melodies.
Undid all I could undo, and never even faced you. I do I. But I can't remember why I left you today. Today you're another life, a happy memory far away.
A friend of mine recently asked me to describe my new album in one sentence, and I didn't have an answer. There's a lot wrapped up in it, interpretation of success and happiness and how truly insignificant our time on Earth is. I started thinking about the songs individually, and they seem somewhat disconnected at first glance, but as I thought about it as a big picture, the through line became much more clear. As I was working on this record, I was really focused on accepting my current circumstances and situations and feelings and just allowing them to be instead of resisting and fighting against what is. So there's a strong sense of acceptance and self-actualization throughout the record, I think. Be it through the experience of a death or fleeting youth or past traumas or accepting yourself or someone else for all that they are and seeing the beauty and even the dark sides. That's a lot more than a sentence. My approach to songwriting was much different than any record I've made previously. I utilized the studio as my writing tool rather than just sitting with a guitar the old-fashioned way. In some cases, I was more or less building tracks and then writing lyrics and melodies over those instead of building everything around the lyrics and the melodies. In the past, I've always worked with somebody else, you know, be it like just one other person co-producing and playing and recording or a band. But this time around, I didn't work with anybody. I didn't write with anyone. I didn't hire an engineer. I just holed up in the bedroom and overdubbed myself. I definitely had the thought that I couldn't do it regularly. So I didn't tell anyone about it until it was done.
Fades away, little moon will go away and it's gone. Fades away every day and I don't know why.
big coping or perspective gaining sort of palate cleansing mechanism for me was painting. Whenever I'd reach a roadblock and didn't know how to progress with a track, I would shift mediums and start painting and try to refresh my mind. Then I would go back and listen to the music that I had done, and oftentimes I would see the path forward.
And I started painting just to have another creative outlet besides music, something that there was no pressure around, no expectations or anything, something that was just for me, really.
I had a lot of fear going into this record, especially once I decided to do it on my own. I was afraid I wouldn't be able to finish it. I mean, as it became more and more legit record, I was having these, you know, regular creative meltdowns. There were many times when I didn't know how to navigate a technical issue, and that would really interrupt my process and frustrate me to no end. You know, there were times when I really couldn't decide if a track was good enough to finish, or if a lyric made sense or was total crap, or if a snare tone was good enough. That's the challenge of recording alone. You only have your perspective, and I don't know if you can always trust it, but I found that the only way for me to really move forward with the project was to try my best to completely shut out the rest of the world and how I thought it might interpret the work that I was doing. Exposed, playing instruments I don't really play, engineering things that I've had little experience with, you know, writing songs about new topics that I would previously be afraid to share with people. I had to really learn to trust my ears and my gut. I felt that it was important to complete it alone, not only for my own ego, but more importantly to say, I did this, I am a woman. Women are capable of anything. Duh. Okay, so what's my album in one sentence? Okay, here's my best try. On My Own is a self-made genre-blending album performed and written by a woman leaning into herself and her sense of acceptance.
Now I see I'm running out of road. Head down and blind, I've been driving through the night, and I've been chasing down a face.